It's the Travis Bartlett Show.
Yo, it's your boy Travis right here, back with another YouTube video. We're gonna have a talk. I really apologize that I haven't been posting a video in a week. For the entire week of Black Friday, I was exhausted, I was tired. I ended up working 6 days for 1 week. And to top it off, I have not been feeling well lately. So I've been kind of coughing and hacking. My body was like hurting. It was aching. I mean, I feel like I was irritated and stressed out as well. I was going to start recording more videos, but for the entire week of that Black Friday week, I haven't been making videos. Now, I'm not saying I took a break from it. Working on holidays is already stressful. If you're working, then you actually understand. And that's why I haven't been posting videos in a week. I wanted to go ahead and let you know that one Black Friday, I had to be at work at 4:30 in the fucking morning. Could you believe? I was tired, but I did get overtime. Let's talk about jobs. Now, this is going to be a part two as a portion. There's some more stuff I should have mentioned in that last video, which obviously I didn't. When it's time to go home, and then you got jobs that wanna make you stay. Let's say you got off at 9 o'clock, but then your managers tell you and say, okay, well, I'm gonna need you to stay, do this and do that. You feel like you're not even allowed to leave, especially when it comes to customers. You can't even leave when customers are in the store when you're already closing the store. And that's just another thing, like customers will walk in at last minute when the store is closed. If you don't understand what they say on the intercom, attention shoppers, we are now closed. Meaning, oh, let's just go on in, we're already closed, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, we're gonna shop here until they kick us out. That is the number one thing I hate. It's like, if we're closed, we're closed. Don't be walking in here at last minute. Like I said, you'll have like management, they'll tell you and say, okay, well, you can't leave until you get this done and that done. It's like they're basically holding us against our will. If it's time for us to go, it's time for us to go. Not, it's time for us to go, but we're here to stay against our entire will because you told us to stay here. When people are bothering you while you are working, that happens all the time, especially when it comes to me and or other people. Like, let's say if I'm busy doing something, you're gonna actually have people have you do stuff at last minute while you're doing your stuff. If I'm busy doing something, don't call me up, I need help doing this, I need help doing that. You got arms and legs, you can do this on your own. Now see, I'm not trying to be selfish or rude about it. If I'm just extremely busy doing something, don't call me and tell me doing stuff, because that's just gonna make me mad, and then it's just gonna make other people get mad at you because you're supposed to be helping these people out, but you're over here working and doing stuff. And of course, it can be very annoying. Let's say if I'm not busy, of course, I wouldn't mind helping at all. And like I said, I'm not trying to be rude about it. I'm not trying to be mean about it. But just don't have me do stuff at last minute while I'm working. If you need me doing something now, let's do it now. Or wait till the next day. I stay working nonstop. Because, you know, when it comes to jobs like me working at Bass Pro. And then there's me doing a lot of videos for YouTube and to entertain you people. I don't mind doing all that. This is just a hobby. The reason why I started doing this is because I got bored and no one didn't want to hang out with me. Whoever's fault it was for not wanting to spend time with me or hang out with me or want to date me, that's on y'all, not me. Does anybody know who Tony Directs is? He is this guy right here that you see on the screen. He is a YouTube creator. I have been trying to actually want to do a video with him. I have been wasting my time trying to get a hold of him. But if I can't get a hold of him, I might have to maybe find somebody else who would want to maybe do a video with me. So Tony Directs, if you're watching this right now, please hit me up. I got to talk to you about making a new video with you. Give you guys a little heads up. I am trying to find me a house to live in. Right now, I am looking at a few apartments. I found one here in Macon, but obviously the person wasn't even over there. I made an appointment to see the apartment and maybe look at it, maybe get like a little tour, you know, just to look at it. And when I showed up there, I waited there for like 15 minutes. And they didn't show up. when I went straight to the office, you know, the main office for the apartments and stuff, turns out one of the residents told me that they were on lunch and they won't be back until 30 minutes. Like, I'm not gonna wait a whole nother 30 minutes just to get a tour in this apartment building. Then I called others and left voicemails, and they didn't even receive my voicemail. They didn't even call me back, which obviously really pissed me off, until I found one over here in Macon. It's called Overlook Gardens, and it's actually in Macon, Georgia. And since I looked at it, it looks like a really great place to live at. See, I was just looking for like a 2-bedroom apartment. That's all I'm looking for. When I called up these people right up here, that they won't have the rooms ready by February. So I was like, okay, I can wait till then. Like, I'm not ready to move, like, right away. Just saying, like, you know, like, if I can wait till February, maybe look at the apartment, that would be perfect. If I can get in at least maybe one apartment, I'm good. But see, I'm not gonna get all my hopes up if I don't get the apartment. But see, I have been telling myself and my parents that I have been wanting to move out since I was like 24. Look at me. I'm 30 years old and still living at my parents. Now, the locations, my family thinks I'm going into a black neighborhood. It's like, first of all, I grew up in Atlanta, Clayton County. I grew up in bad neighborhoods. It don't really matter. See, it don't matter if you're actually in a good neighborhood or if you're in a bad neighborhood. Either way, things are going to happen. Like, they think, like, I should be better off in a beautiful white neighborhood, which obviously is not gonna happen. I lived in a neighborhood full of black people, and did you hear me complain about it? No. And then they want to talk about all the bad areas I'm choosing. I said, we're already now living in Macon, and everybody knows if you live in Macon, it's already a bad area. I mean, you could look up websites. You can even look up a video on YouTube that says why Macon's a dangerous area to live in. But technically, I went from living in Atlanta to now living in Macon, and you're telling me that we're actually in a good neighborhood. That's just bull. Like, I remember when I was like in middle school, we used to have these next door neighbors. They were Mexicans. The neighbors came over here, saw me just standing there waiting for my bus to come pick me up. And then my mom and then my sister came along. They started telling us stories about how their house was broken into when they were asleep. They said they had their TVs taken away, DVD players. They've had all kinds of electronics that was stolen from them while they were asleep. To top it off, I don't know what happened to them. All I remember is that they moved right back to Mexico. And then when I was in high school, we've actually had our bicycles stolen thanks to my stepdad. I can tell you, years ago, my stepdad was a drunk, but he was always there for me and my sister. And one day, he left the garage door open and someone actually went and stole our bikes. And we had to keep buying new ones. But like I said, it don't matter where you live. It don't matter where you're staying at. Either way, things are gonna happen. So anyway, that's my show for today. If you guys like to, please subscribe to my channel. Please don't forget to stalk all my social medias. I think that's about it. Peace.